So on one of my recent videos, I asked if people can recommend some Australian music for me. As I said on that, I don't really know anything about Australian music, to be honest with you. One band I do love is the DMAs. I love their music. I found out about them on a football forum that I visit a couple of years ago, and I've been listening to them ever since. Obviously, I know like Kylie Minogue in the UK and stuff like that, but someone recommended, or actually two people recommended this singer. This is why I wanted to check out. It's called John Farnham. And the reason I wanted to check this one out is because I've actually never heard of John Farnham at all. And I thought this would be interesting. At least I can find out about someone new and some new music as well. They recommend this, which is Help Live with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra. Not too sure what sort of genre of music to expect here, but just interested and kind of intrigued to find out more and see what's going on with this one. But yeah, keep recommending some other Australian music. Let's check out this one first.
Here's an oldie but a goodie.
And it looks, yeah, quite old as well. Quite grainy, the footage. You can see the orchestra there, man. Looks pretty cool setup he's got there. Okay, yeah, definitely like this looks 80s or something like that. I like the hairdo, man, and stuff. Let's just hear. Whoa. Oh, I thought he did that as well. Wait, sorry, yeah, I just tapped my heart because one of the things I love about music is it's probably the same as with sports, is when the fans are so invested. I recently watched some American like R&B singer do a performance in the UK recently where the crowd basically sang the whole song so loud with him, he had minimal input. And I don't know, something about it just gave me goosebumps. When you see like a fan base that's so invested, you can already hear it with these fans. He was about to start singing. He heard the response from the fans and he was like, you know what, I'm gonna let them have a moment here that we can share. Let's just get back into that and go back and hear that again. But his voice already, man, I can tell it's got this kind of rock, kind of rock feel to it, man. Like maybe that 80s anthemic rock music type sound to it. You know, it's very powerful. A lot of personality in it. You can see he feels it. He's like almost surprised. Yeah, man. Wow. I love that connection between fans and performer, man.
Thank you.
Fair play. Whoa. Whoa. Wait a minute. Oh, okay, yes, man, this is so good. His voice is stunning, man. Listen to the power and strength in his voice, but it's so controlled as well. But what I was going to say, I think this is, I just kind of like realized the word help. I think this is the Beatles song, Help. Listening to the lyrics of the song and the build up to like saying help there. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is like maybe his version of the Beatles song. So that's gave it another bit of context for me there to actually make a comparison, because actually already this is kind of blowing the Beatles version out of the water in a different way. Like theirs is like a more maybe composed way of singing. It's like, I can't sing, so I'm not going to do, but it's like a bit more like on a certain level. His is just power, man, and just like feeling and emotion. And the way that changed with that big backdrop of the stage with the lighting and the drum coming in, we have to see that again, man. Listen to that, man. Yeah, man, that is the Beatles song. Oh man, come on! Yes! Now my life is changed in so many ways. My independence seems to vanish in the head. Holy shit, man. But every now and then I feel so whimsical. And I know that I just need. My God, man, listen to the control in his voice. He's hitting like so many different notes right up to that high note, man. Shit, man, this could actually be like better than the Beatles, man. I knew I had a feeling I'm going to feel like, especially with the size of audience there, I feel like I'm going to be embarrassed that I don't know who this singer is. Maybe he just never wasn't big in the UK. Maybe I was probably a small child if I was even born here. So maybe that's why I don't know him, but what a voice! Yeah, man. He's making it look so easy too. The big camera there, man, definitely the 80s, the moustache on the guy. The heart. Yeah, man, it's definitely the 80s with the saxophone solo. One of my favourite thing about 80s music, man. Okay, man, yeah. I'm glad someone recommended this as the live version with this orchestra, man. And this isn't like your normal orchestra. I got some other instruments and things here, but it really adds so much to the performance. Like, what an amazing concert this must have been to actually see him with this type of voice, but with that backing of an orchestra like this. I can only imagine how that must have felt inside that arena. But his voice, man, is actually giving me goosebumps, man. Yeah, good respect to the saxophonist there as well. When I was young, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's. Oh my God, this performance is making me very happy, man. But now those days are gone, oh. I'm not so self-assured. Now I find I've changed my mind. I've opened up the door. Help me if you can. Oh my God. Listen to that connection between him and his fans, man. I'm not exaggerating. This is one of the best voices I have ever heard. God, yes, man, this is so good. Listen, hey. man. Yes. No, how do I not know him, man? I'm so sad that I don't know him. But this is why I like having this sort of channel where I can like find out about things that I never knew about, man. This singer, John Farnham, man, is just never crossed my life. I've never became aware of him for some reason, but listen to that, man. It's just, it's epic, man. His voice, everything about it is so unique. It's so powerful. Let's just...
Thank you, Melvin. Good night. Be careful. Thank you. The Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, ladies. Yeah.
That was absolutely fantastic, man. His voice. I'm sad that I never knew about him before, but I'm happy that I now do know about him and I can now go through his back catalogue. I think I'll definitely be checking out more live performances if there's more from him, because singing live is such a different level of ability compared to recording tracks on music. To be able to perform like this live is just something special, man. To have that gravitas, to have that kind of ability, it's kind of blown my mind, man. So yeah, please recommend some more music from him. I will definitely be checking out more soon. That was fantastic.